What is up, YouTube? Welcome to a new series on the channel, the FIFA 20 Career Mode. Now, as you can see, we are going to roll with Swindon Town in League 2 of English football. It's the fourth tier of the English football system. Now, Swindon Town has been one of my favorite teams over the past couple of years. This year, they're looking to get into the promotion area and get promoted into League 1. So we're going to see if we can do that. We're going to see if we can take them all the way up to the Premier League and hopefully through the Europa League and into the Champions League and see how much we can win. I'm really excited to bring this career mode to you guys. Go ahead and take a look at the squad. Let's see what we got rolling. Up top, we got Yates, a 22-year-old striker, only 5'9". Behind him at the cam, we got Keshi Anderson. He is going to be the star of the team, I promise you guys. Over here on the left, we got Kane Woolery. Our captain in the middle, Doty. I hope I say these names right as well. Just bear with me, guys. Lydon, next to him. Over on the far right, here we got Isgrove. He looks to be a promising player as well, 26, 65 rated. On the back right, we got Hunt. Next to him, we got Baudry and Conroy in the middle with Friars over on the left side. We got a nice set of reserves down here too. Romanski, Duran, Iandolo, Scotty Twine, Ains down here, and Matthews. Let's go ahead and look for some players that we can acquire during this first transfer window. And we're going to start out with a young prodigy that we will have to bring in at some point, and that's Ayo Akinola, a 19-year-old striker right now. He's with Toronto FC, so we're going to scout him and add him to the short list. He is going to be the future of our attack. I promise you guys that we're going to find a way to bring him in at some point. Next up, we're going to look for Derek Etienne Jr. Hope I'm saying that right. Looks like he's with FC Cincinnati, on loan at FC Cincinnati. I thought he was with the New York Red Bulls, because he is, but he's 22. He's a little bit higher caliber. The guy we're going to look at is Chris Gosselin, a 19-year-old midfielder. Looks to be promising. He's a little on the small side. So he might end up being a backup to Keshi Anderson or someone we can play in attacking situations. The guy we're going to look up is Lalas Abubakar. He's a big physical center back who I've used in FIFA 19, and he's really good. Next guy we're going to look at is Julian Dunn. We need to find the future of our defense here, and this 18-year-old center back, also with Toronto FC, who is my favorite MLS squad. He looks promising, so we're going to go ahead and scout him, add him to the short list. Hopefully in 12 days, when we get those reports back, we can pick up some of those guys. We got this preseason tournament. Not going to play any of these games. First gameplay will be in the next episode, which is hopefully out very soon after this one. Doty welcoming us to the team. Glad to be here. Doty, we're very excited with the team we got. All right, so here's our updated formation. I like using two at the top and then Anderson up there at the cam as well. It presents a lot of good attacking opportunities, but more importantly, the defense. We got five across the back line. Defending isn't my strong suit, as I'm sure we will probably see. Doty, the captain of the team, locking down. He can do it all, so it's good to have him in. Glashlin at this right center midfielder. That door's probably going to be revolving until we can find somebody that can really lock down that position. Maybe Diagoraga is a good option there. He can kind of do it all. Better defensively, McGlashan has good pace. So I think we're going to go with Broadbent in the middle, but we can switch that around as well. Friars on the left side. I think he's going to be getting a lot of playing time over there. Reed is going to be our backup as of right now. Romanski is also an option with Iandolo. Jaya Simi? We're going to have to get him into the subs because he looks like he could be promising. He's got really good pace, young, decent size. Kane's down here as a CDM, but that's the team sheet we're going to go with for the first preseason tournament, it looks like. End of game one is a 0-0 draw, or as we say over here in America, it's a 0-0 tie, but I'm going to go with the 0-0 because it feels like I know what I'm talking about. We got 1 point. We're second right now. We're Trapani. Trapani won their first game, second match here of the tournament. Another draw. 1-1 this time. Doty getting in there. Hunt picking up a yellow card. Make up a switch here. Let's take out McGlashlin and put in either Isgrove or Diagoraga. Let's go with Diagoraga. He performs a more all-around game than McGlashlin, so let's see what he can do in there. We got a loan offer for Romanski. I think we're going to go ahead and accept that. He's young and he needs a lot of playing time. We are playing Trapani. This is gonna be for advancing in the tournament, most likely. And we lose 1-0. We have a long way to go if we want to move up and gain promotion and eventually make it to the Premier League. I hope I don't spend more than a season in League 2 or League 1 for that matter. I hope we get to the Champions League by Season 3. I want to get to the Premier League as fast as possible and start playing in the Europa League, and the goal is to take home the Champions League. We can move on to the scouting reports coming in from the players we put on our shortlist. Ayo Akinola, currently a 61, decent value, not a lot of wage, so we're going to try to bring him in. Julian Dunn as well, a couple other guys that are just popped up but haven't scouted yet. And Tene is pretty valuable, so I've don't know if we're going to be able to afford him, but he's on loan anyway. Aslan looks nice and cheap. The young guy, we might be able to bring in right away, being that he has a release clause. Ayo Akinola, he's the goal here. We definitely want to bring him in as soon as possible. Let's go ahead and approach. Looks like this player is not willing to relocate at this time. Now that is pretty depressing. Gosselin is next. Looks like he's going to be available to talk to, being that he has that release clause. Club isn't willing to sell, but we're going to go ahead and approach him. We're going to pay that release clause because I believe he could be a future star on this team. There's our manager, Adrian Hammer. We're going to go ahead and give him the rotation role, and he is all good with that. I probably could have got away with making him a prospect. Wants a 5-year contract, that's perfect with us. He's going to be in our long-term plans. No release clause, even better. 1600, that's fine. A small signing bonus. So looks like the only one we were able to get was Gosselin. We're going to go ahead and stick Gosselin up in here. We're going to get rid of May. And just like that, Keshi Anderson becomes a 66 rated player already. He is the star of the team. So as high as he can go is where the team's going to go. Swindon's European International Cup early exit wasn't quite the debut fans were hoping for. How much does it impact the squad? I got faith in my team. We're going to be just fine. Promotion more than a dream for Swindon. Definitely have what it takes. So, and the team morale is going up, which is very good. Gosselin's transfer. Will he get his first minutes on the pitch? He will prove he's the right man for the job. Gaiaraga has received an injury in training, so we're going to have to take him out. Stick Gosselin in there. Squad's looking good, looking healthy. So this is what we're going to roll with for game 1.